So this is how you control it. This is ZFS sync property. And the slide covers the content about what the properties are. You can just look at the documentation. I got to zip through here. I'm already over time. The log bias is new. This gives you, Richard talked about it, gives you the ability to tune kind of how if you have a separate log device, how that's used, whether your data set is using it, goes to the log device to reduce latency, or whether it bypasses the log device to get better throughput on streaming disk. So streaming workloads can benefit from turning the log bias to throughput. Bunch of new device support. I'm just not going to list them here. There's just so much stuff that's changed in between build 104 to build 134, plus the stuff we've backported after that. A bunch of stuff. Bunch of stuff. The note here about the improved CPU support is there's both performance enhancements in some of the code, and then there's also better support for FMA and fault management when the CPUs error. Gosh, I really want more time. So for 3.1, here's a quick overview of the day of what we're planning. No promises. So there's three big things apart from additional device support. The one thing I really want to talk to is the SCSI unmap, iSCSI unmap. So the idea here is that with iSCSI unmap, you have the ability for the initiator, which would be a remote client, for example, a VMware works, VMware guest or whatever, to indicate when the data is no longer needed. Now the benefit to this is that you now have the ability on the target to data collect. You need file system support in the initiator, and here's the killer app for this, virtualization. You have a bunch of VMs sharing a single iSCSI pool. Okay? If you allocate correctly and don't over allocate, you may have to make some unfortunate decisions about how much space you give each client. What iSCSI unmap allows us to do is over provision, and when a client can temporarily use a bunch of space, and as long as they delete it, I get to get it back. Without iSCSI unmap, when a guest deletes the data, the host has no way of knowing about it. It hasn't been informed, and the data is lost. So even though the file system and the guest thinks it's deleted the data, the virtual drive, the Comstar target, doesn't know about it. iSCSI unmap fixes this. We're adding encrypted data set support. It's kind of very experimental. It's probably going to change in the final 4.0 release. It's not the code that Darren Moffat wrote. It's rather a preliminary version using LoFi. There's not really new code in the kernel. There's a couple of changes, small, modest changes to a couple of the commands to make this work. But we're basically going to allow you to start with this as a low-risk early feature. And then in 4.0, we're going to have the same ZFS crypto that is based on Darren Moffat's code, more tightly integrated with ZFS directly. We're expecting better Active Directory integration. It's all code's already in there. Better diagnosability, a better configuration interface, and just generally, it's just going to be easier to use. If you're using SIFS in environments with AD, you'll be happier with 3.1 than you were with previous releases. Improved device support. I'm not even going to list them here, so we'll just go past it. I'm almost 5 minutes overdue, but we're almost done. So. Zip along. So our 4.0 plans, which are very tentative, I think I already mentioned this. This is where my focus team is. I've got engineers all over the world working on this stuff and growing. And by the way, if you know some rock star kernel programmers, I've got more work on my plate than I have engineers, and I have money for the engineers. So I'm looking for people who are superstars. So to make this go faster, better, this is actually an amazing time right now. The 4.0 base plan, we're going to move from build 134 to a Lumos. I'm going to talk a lot more about a Lumos at 4 o'clock, and I hope most of you or all of you will be there. And the point of this is primarily that we'll be fully open source, or at least mostly fully open source. We'll also be switching the command line tools to the Illumos Solaris baseline from the GNU baseline. The primary thing here is that the GNU baseline, the differences in the key differentiators there for the GNU tools have been pretty much resolved, and we're resolving some more of them as we go. So it's going to be more familiar for those of you coming from a familiar Solaris background. We're going to get rid of this whole schizophrenia with the, you know, the sun personality and all that stuff. It's going to be just be better. And we're updating the Debian base. We're moving to a newer version of the Debian stuff for the non-Illumos bits. Storage enhancements, I really don't want to break these down, but I can tell you that there's stuff in the roadmap that I'm not ready to commit to. Here's why I don't list out breakdown features. I don't want to tell you I'm going to deliver something until I have code in hand. If I'm going to make you a promise, I'm going to keep it. And I can't keep a promise if I don't actually have the code in hand. But I do know that we have work in progress on enhancements for ZFS. These are new innovative things. Enhancements for ZFS, enhancements for SIFS, enhancements for ComStar, and enhancements for NFS. Some of these things have been alluded to here. Some of them I can talk about under NDA. So there's also going to be new storage hardware protocols coming into the next Senna product in the 4.0 timeframe. It's going to be really cool. Again, I can't talk about these more openly, partly because I don't want to make promises I can't keep, partly because, you know, there's business reasons. But some of those are we could talk about further under NDA, and I'm not sure who you talk to get all that squared away. Probably Brad or somebody like that. So that's it. We're all done. Thanks.